Our world is constantly evolving. As time moves forward, things change, which is why it's important to stay informed. Throughout the year, there are dozens of professionals that share their expertise with the community through lectures sponsored by local government agencies and area not-for-profits. And each month, we'll feature one of these visiting professors as they discuss the latest current events and trends. So grab a notebook and pull up a chair because the lecture hall is about to begin.
Hi everyone, again I'm Crystal Woodard. I am a third year teacher at Fort Pierce Central High School. And we're here to tell you a little bit about how we've built this program and some of the really awesome hands-on science activities we've done. So I'm going to introduce some of the speakers that we're going to have today. I've already introduced myself. I graduated from Florida Tech about 3 years ago, and I had a double major in marine biology and science education. When I started at Central, I was a biology teacher, and I requested to start a marine science program, and they let me last year. And I've grown from one marine science class to 8 now. So we've really expanded. And it's all because of these awesome students and all of these great projects, labs, and field trips that we've done. So some of our speakers today, we have Cassie Williams, if you just please stand up and wave. She's the president of our Marine Science Club. She was my student last year in my very first marine science class. All of my speakers today are seniors in high school, and they are graduating and going on to college. So Cassie will be attending Santa Fe, and she will be majoring in zoology and minoring in marine biology. So I love that the passion for science has translated for them into a future career. We also have Savannah Thomason, who is a current student of mine and a club member, and she is also going to Santa Fe and majoring in zoology. We also have Lizzie Andrews speaking with us today. She is a current student of mine and a club member, and she will be going to FIU and majoring in physical therapy. Our last speaker, Josh Walker. He is a previous student and club member. He actually graduated from Central last year. He's currently attending IRSC, and he wants to take my job someday. He wants to be a marine science teacher. A couple honorable mentions. I also have Austin Thiel here, who is one of my club members supporting our club. And I also have Danielle Leiss here, who is one of my current students supporting us today. Okay, so about my class, marine science incorporates all aspects of science. So we study zoology, geology, chemistry, physics, all aspects of science. And I like to incorporate a lot of hands-on activities, labs, and even some field trips. So today, some of my students are going to tell you about some of their favorite field trips, labs, and activities. And we are going to start with Miss Cassie Williams.
Hello. I'm Cassie. As she just mentioned, I am the president of our Marine Science Club, and I go to Fort Pierce Central High School. I'm looking to go to Santa Fe College. I'm very, very interested in animals and biology and zoology, so I'm hoping to make a career out of it. I'm going to talk about some projects and field trips we did. We did a build a boat project, which you can see. That's my boat in the bottom left-hand corner. We did that project to learn about like the buoyancy of our different boats that we made and how the wind affected how our boat sailed. My boat actually won the fastest boat contest. I just made it out of paper, so I was really surprised when it won. I also went on a lot of the field trips with the marine science class and now with the club. I went on a Florida oceanographic trip, which you can see right here in this middle picture. We did some water quality testing, and we got to do their nature trail, which was beautiful, and we got to do some hands-on stuff with stingrays and other marine life. And we also went on a Smithsonian field trip, and we got to do some seining and get in the water and see kind of how they collect the wildlife that they have at the Smithsonian Aquarium there. So, and that's just a picture of me and some of the other girls who went with me to the Keys last year for a snorkeling trip.
Okay. Hi, so in September, we volunteered at the Indian River Lagoon Science Festival with St. Lucie County Water Management at their booth, and we helped with the kids. We made homemade water filters with them. And then recently we did a squid dissection lab in class, and we got to look at all the different organs and structures in the squid. And I even got to take out the pen from inside the squid and use the ink from the ink sac to write my initials on the paper, which was pretty cool. And recently we also went to Florida Tech's Vero Beach Marine Lab, and we were able to see their different aquaculture projects. And we also got to sample lionfish and an algae smoothie. And after, we went to the Sebastian Inlet and participated in plankton collecting.
Hi everyone, I'm Lizzie Andrews. As noted that I'm going to FIU to study physical therapy. And first of the things that we did was, in the beginning of the year, she taught us about the ocean and the floor, and we learned about like the seamounts and the mid-Atlantic ridges and stuff, like different things. And we actually built a diagram, as you can see right there, of the floor. And then we did like all the different things and labeled them and stuff. For the second thing, we've done two dissections, the squid and then the shark, which was my favorite. We got to actually, we learned about the anatomy, and then we like cut it open, and we actually got to take out the brain and the heart. And so it's really cool. And for one of the many field trips that we do, we went to the Key Largo, and we went to John Pennekamp State Park, and we got to go kayaking in the mangroves, and we labeled like the different type of mangroves and like told the difference between them and what they all did. And then we got to snorkel in the corals, so that was my favorite trip. So.
Hi, I'm Josh Walker, and like Ms. Woodard said, I'm at IRSC, so I can study, so I can take over for her whenever she decides she's ready to leave. And we're going to be going to Discovery Cove. We'll be able to do a dolphin encounter and swim around with dolphins. And then we're going to be going to two or three. I know we're going to two aquariums, and then we're going to the zoo to look at different animals and marine life. We're also going to go to Crystal River so we can snorkel with manatees. And then we're just going to Busch Gardens.
Thank you, Josh. So we've been raising money all year to go on this awesome trip to gain some more hands-on experience. Some of the other wonderful things that we've done is get involved with the community. Okay, in the fall, we actually did a local beach cleanup, and we would like to get involved with some more beach cleanups in the future. Also, on one of our field trips, we assisted in making oyster bags to help with the water filtration in the Indian River Lagoon. So here are my kids hard at work and bagging up those oysters. We also did the water quality testing in one of the field trips that one of my students told you about. This was especially important when we had these toxic algae blooms going on in the fall. So we got to see, you know, how the water was affected by that. And we did volunteer, as Savannah told you, at the Indian River Lagoon Science Festival, helping the little kids learn about water filtration with sand and gravel. So just to wrap up what we talked about today, we're the Fort Pierce Central Marine Science Club in class, and we are trying to get more students and children active in hands-on science, particularly marine, but all science. Well, thank you for having us tonight, and thank you for letting us share, you know, how we've built this program at Central.